हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू एकलव्य ड्रिवन बाय पैशन। अमंग द सीरीज ऑफ लेक्चर्स ऑन एयरक्राफ्ट परफॉर्मेंस, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द टॉपिक जनरल इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन। कंसीडर एन एयरक्राफ्ट इन फ्लाइट एज शोन इन फिगर। Fundamental equations that governs translation motion through air must be established to study performance. The initial aircraft in the figure is now expressed with forces resolved in the new figure. We see that flight path, that is the direction of motion of aircraft, is inclined at an angle theta with respect to horizontal. Four forces acting on the aircraft are lift L acting perpendicular to the flight direction, drag T acting parallel to the flight path direction, thrust T inclined at an angle alpha T with respect to flight path, weight W acts vertically downwards, always acting towards the center of Earth. If we consider a curvilinear path as discussed in video lecture 2, this curvilinear path at a given point on the path sets up two mutually perpendicular axes, one along the direction of flight path and the other normal to flight path. In simple words, at a point on a curvilinear path, we can resolve the forces parallel to flight path and perpendicular to flight path. According to Newton's second law, force can be expressed as mass into acceleration. Now, applying Newton's second law along flight path, we get summation of forces parallel to the flight path equal to mass into acceleration. This in turn can be expressed as mass into change in velocity by change in time. Let us denote this as equation 1, where summation of F parallel is summation of forces parallel to flight path. A is equal to dv by dt is acceleration along flight path. V is instantaneous value of aircraft's flight velocity. In the similar manner, applying Newton's second law perpendicular to flight path, we get summation of forces perpendicular to flight path equal to mass into acceleration. Acceleration perpendicular to flight path is centrifugal acceleration. We can express it as mass into velocity square divided by radius of curvature. Let us denote this as equation 2, where summation of F perpendicular is summation of forces perpendicular to flight path, V square by RC is acceleration normal to curved path with radius of curvature RC, M V square by RC is centrifugal force. Now from figure, resolving the forces parallel to flight path, we get summation of forces parallel to the flight path equal to, here we see that thrust force is inclined at an angle alpha t with respect to flight path. So when we resolve it, we'll be getting the term t cos alpha t. Now considering the direction along the flight path to be positive, we can denote this term as T cos alpha T. When we take a drag force, it is also acting parallel to flight path but in the direction opposite to that of flight path. So we'll be denoting it with negative sign. In the similar manner, when we resolve weight of an aircraft, we will be getting W sin theta along the flight path, and it will be in the direction opposite to that of flight path, so we'll be allotting negative sign to it. So overall, we'll be getting summation of forces parallel to the flight path equal to thrust into cos alpha t minus d minus W sin theta. Let us denote this as equation 3. Similarly, from figure, resolving forces perpendicular to flight path, we get summation of forces perpendicular to flight path will be equal to, see, forces which are acting perpendicular to flight path are lift force. Thrust force is acting at an angle alpha t. When we resolve it, we'll be getting t sin alpha t, and weight is acting at an angle theta, so by resolving it, we'll be getting W cos theta. And if we see lift and t sin alpha t will be acting in the upward direction. If we denote the forces acting in the upward direction to be positive, we'll be getting L plus t sin alpha t, and W cos theta will be acting in the downward direction, so we'll be taking it as minus W cos theta. So overall, summation of forces perpendicular to the flight path will be equal to L plus T sin alpha t minus W cos theta. Let us denote this as equation 4. Now, combining equation 1 and 3, as the LHS are same, that is summation of forces parallel to the flight path, we get t cos alpha t minus W sin theta equal to m dv by dt. Let us denote this as equation 5. In the similar manner, combining equation 2 and 4, we get L plus T sin alpha T minus W cos theta will be equal to mass into velocity square divided by radius of curvature. Let us denote this as equation 6. The above two equations, equation 5 and equation 6, are the governing equation of motion for an aircraft in flight. Using this governing equation, we can find out the performance characteristics of an aircraft, which will be discussed in the future videos. Please do like, comment and subscribe. We'll catch you again in the next video. Thank you.